question I'm frequently asked is in a very sensitive area. It's a question involving isoflavones. It's in an area involving soy. Soy happens to be a food that I love. One of our favorite things to do at home is Muriel will take soybeans, edamame, a Japanese treat, and she'll saute them up in a pan. Sometimes she'll do the Mediterranean style. Sometimes she'll do more of a Japanese style, but they are absolutely delicious. They're a great source of protein, a great source of fiber, a great source of protective phytonutrients, including isoflavones. And in fact, if there's one food that's healthy for a man's prostate as he ages, it's soy. And it's inescapable if you read the research. But where there's an interesting undercurrent of other, not so much research or discussion, is with soy and breast cancer. The research I read on soy and women who have an abundant intake of soy is that they have a significantly reduced risk of breast cancer. I think there's a lot of misconceptions surrounding the isoflavones, which can often be referred as the phytoestrogen effect of soy. The phytoestrogen effect of soy is basically an insignificant estrogenic effect. Nevertheless, if we look at the populations on this planet that consume record amounts of soy, far beyond what we consume in Western society, their rates of breast cancer are a tiny fraction of ours. And as they adopt our eating habits and reduce their soy intake, one of the things that's observed is their breast cancer risk goes up. So of course you must defer, if this is a topic that's relevant to you, you must defer to your treating physician, you must defer to the opinions of your doctors, your oncologist, whoever that might be. But again, when I look at soy and I look at the research and the clinical studies, even when you look at the research involving women previously diagnosed with breast cancer and you look at rates of recurrence, soy exerts a positive influence. Also, by the way, weight loss exerts a positive influence on recurrence of breast cancer. And in addition to weight loss, simply being active and exercising, so engaging positive lifestyle steps after a diagnosis of breast cancer, independent of everything else that gets done, all the new treatments and things they might have available, independent of all of that, that significantly reduces the rate and the risk of recurrence. A number of years ago, I wrote a short booklet on breast cancer prevention. And in terms of breast cancer prevention, it was simply talking about the things we could do from a dietary and from a lifestyle standpoint to reduce a woman's risk of breast cancer. And most importantly, we need to follow the guidance and direction of our doctor. But to the extent we can eat a healthier diet, a diet rich in fruits and vegetables, less animal fat and animal products when you look at the clinical studies, and rich in soy, it seems to be, appears to be consistently associated with a reduced risk of breast cancer. So whether it's our women's wellness, our ultimate women's wellness, our soy meal replacement, our secure soy meal replacement, I don't look at those at all as being risky foods or risky products. But again, you have to follow the guidance of your physician. In fact, I view them as risk reduction products, just the opposite. In terms of our meal replacement, we also make our secure meal replacement with whey protein. We also make it with our marine collagen peptide protein. So soy is not the only choice. But again, I think there's a great deal of alarmist approach to soy. And funnily enough, they always say follow the money. I think part of the reason there's so much negative press about soy, certainly in the United States, you don't read this in China or Japan, where it's a staple of their healthy diet, a much healthier diet than our own. I think is that the meat industry, the dairy industry, they don't like to see this very environmentally sound vegetable source of protein proliferating the American diet. And of course, in our case, ours is all non-GMO. And that's another discussion. There'll be another quick video talking about GMO and not GMO here.